if you're building an app where your user's privacy is important, and let's be honest, it always is, and you're building a .NET MAUI app, then this video is for you. The other day when I was browsing the internet, I found this amazing plugin for .NET MAUI, which allows you to enable to kind of like secure your screen of your app. I'll show you in a minute what that means, but basically whenever you're building an app where your user's privacy is important, then this could be really helpful. You might know of apps that don't allow you to take screenshots, that don't really allow you to take, you know, whenever you go into the multitask view on like iOS, you get all the apps next to each other and you can see the last screen that was shown in that app. You might not always want that. If you are creating a banking app and you have your bank account balance on there, you don't want your phone lying around and someone just boop, opening that multitask view and seeing your balance, right? That's something that you might not want to do, or someone looking over your shoulder. Is that happening now? Okay. So you don't want that to happen. And there is ways to kind of obscure that for both iOS and Android. And this plugin makes it really, really easy to do that. So let's see how to implement that. So here in Visual Studio, as always, I just created a file new .NET MAUI project. This is basically the vanilla project. I only already installed the plugin. So if you go over to your project, you do right click and you do manage NuGet packages. Here we are. And then you're going to search for Plugin.Maui.ScreenSecurity, right? So you're going to find that one. And as of right now, this is version 1.0.0. So it's a stable version, if that means anything. And it only has 51 downloads. So you'll be among the first people to know about this plugin and to use it inside of your app. How cool is that? Also, be sure to go over to the repository star of this project if that is something that you like and you want to support the author. Maybe you can sponsor them. Always important stuff to look into here. Now, if you've installed that, just install it on your project. It should go automatically. As mentioned, it only works right now for Android and iOS. So if we look into the CS proj, just to give you a little pro tip right here, how that works. It's going to be included only for Android. So only whenever the target framework is Android is going to install this, and for iOS all the same, just so that it doesn't make for any errors whenever you're using Windows or Tizen or any of the other platforms. So with that in place, we have all this and we don't need to do any initialization in the MAUI program. That's how it typically goes with plugins. You have to go into the MAUI program and add a little initialization line, but none of that. And for this screen, I'm not going to touch the UI that much actually. For this screen is just the waving.net bot as you know and love it. But let's pretend that this is a very secret screen, right? So now how to use the plugin. So there's a couple of ways to do that. You can actually go into the MAUI program, and this is probably the way that you want to do it. You can go and here say builder.services. You can register it as a dependency service, and you can do add. I think you can use a add singleton for this case, and we can say, hey, we want to do the, I think we can just do this iScreenSecurity. Isn't that one? iScreenSecurity. There we go. Well, you can figure it out. It's also in the documentation. You can definitely use it like this. If you really want to be sure that this works, you can do screen security, so you can actually add the right instance in here. You can do screensecurity.default. This is also how we recommend doing it now for what was formerly known as Xamarin Essentials, .NET MAUI Essentials. You can register it the same way. And now you can just do dependency injection on this thing, right? But you can also use the static instance of this that I'm just registering here. So let's just do that for this example. Actually, let me just keep this in here so you know how to do this for the sample code right here. If you use DI, use this. There we go. So you can use this. I'm just going to use a static instance. So I'm just going to do screensecurity.default. So I'm just going to copy this one. And I'm going to go into the code behind my main page. And you can do this in a couple of different ways, right? You can do it whenever you push a button, whenever you go to a certain screen. So that's totally up to you, whatever you want to hide in your application. Now, at this point, it's probably also good to note that, you know, while this is a handy feature, it's not, you know, airtight. It's not all waterproof. Is that all sayings in English? I don't know. But it's not going to be completely safe for anything, right? Nothing is completely safe. So this is definitely helpers that can help you make your privacy for your user a little bit more secure. But definitely this is not the silver bullet that you're looking for to make your app really secure for everyone in every scenario. So it's up to you where you want to use this. You could do like, hey, override on appearing. So whenever this screen appears or any other screen, you can do it right there, or you can just do it here in the constructor if you want. So let's just do that. Screen security.default. It automatically adds the right using right here with Visual Studio plugin.maui.screensecurity. And you have a couple of APIs. And you can also see there's a lot of exclamation marks here. I'll get to that in a little bit. But the most important ones are here: enable screen security protection and disable screen security protection, right? So we got a couple of variations of that. Let's just do that actually. Enable screen security protection right here. There we have that one. And then whenever we press the button, let's just do it like that. Or you could use the override on disappearing. Here we are. So whenever you leave the screen, you can then kind of like disable the screen protection if that's what you want, right? But right now, just for demonstration purposes, I'm just going to do it on the button press so we can actually have a little action that disables this behavior. So let's just say disable screen protection here. And you can already see this is not available for anything but Android, basically. So you can see that here mentioned. It's a big tooltip, but it's supported for Android only. Again, we'll get to that in a little bit. So disable screen security protection. Okay, and if I run this now on Android, then we'll just see the waving.net bot. And whenever we go into like the multitask screen, it should be obscured in any way that the Android version of your device is doing that. And we should not be able to take screenshots. And I think even the screen recording is disabled as well. It might even be, I've seen a demonstration, which is really cool, where they mirror the screen through a tool named Visor. So they have a physical device, they're mirroring that through the computer. And even there, that screen doesn't show up. So you can really not share and do anything with that, just to prevent your user from doing anything stupid. So if I go to the multitask view here, I can see, here we are. So it's blanked out, right? It's gone. And if I try to take a screenshot, then it says disabled by your admin all the way down here at the bottom. So you can do anything here, which is really cool. And if I now go back in here and I do click me, this disables the screen protection. And if I go back into this multi thing here right now, you can see, hey, there is the screenshot of my last used screen and I can take a screenshot, right? This is just allowed. So this is really cool. This is really a helpful functionality to do that privacy stuff. Now, you already noted, I already mentioned it a couple of times, so it would be hard to get around it, is that this is only working for Android. So what we want to do is do if Android right here, and then here we can do end if, right? So same for the other one down here, just so we're sure that this only works for Android. Now, if the author of this plugin gets to watch this video, this is something that I would love to improve in this plugin. Because now you will get a lot of if Android, if iOS, and I get why that is, but it would be cooler if I don't care about all the customization options, or if I can have the customization options in just one method call, because now I have to do all these if devs. I don't really like them personally. So it would be cool if we could just have one API that is supported for Android and iOS, and you will take care of all the multi-targeting there. But anyway, that's all aside. So if we want to do something for iOS, let's do if that's how this works, iOS, I can now do screen. Whoops, I have to switch over here from Android to iOS. So I get the IntelliSense and that kind of stuff. But you already know it worked like that. Screen security.default. And now I can see what is there for iOS. And iOS has a couple of options. You can use a color overlay, basically. So you will get a certain color that is overlaid on the whole screen. You can do a full image if that's what you want. You can do a fancy blur if that's what you want. So that's why this is split out between Android and iOS. And I think, like I said, for Android, it's also enable screen security protection, like for screenshots and screen recording and all those kinds of things. For iOS, you have to specifically also enable the screen recording protection, right? So that's also something that you need to do separate. So you have like the multitasking going in there and the screen recording protection. So that's two separate things that we got going on here. So let's just do the blur screen protection. And you can do a theme style. So you can also make a difference between light and dark. You could look at the setting that the user has set for their operating system with the .NET MAUI APIs. But you can just choose one of these. So let's do the light white theme here. And again, if we then do that here, down here, we can disable it again. So else if iOS, I'm going to do screen security dot default dot disable. And you also have to do the disable blur screen protection, right? So there is that. Again, this could be one single API that just says disable screen protection. I set it too often. And it will just disable all the things regardless of how I set it, right? That would be even cooler. Now, if I switch over here to my iOS target here at the top, I connected my Mac machine to this Windows machine, and now I can just select my iOS simulators right here, and I can start connecting to that, and with the remote simulator, it will show up here on my machine so that I can kind of like screen mirror my iOS simulator that's actually running on the Mac on my Windows machine, and I can just click through it as I'm debugging any iOS application on Windows. How crazy cool is that? So let's just wait for that to come up. Here we go. The iOS simulator is coming up. Installing this application. And here, so this is a iPhone 14, so I should be able to swipe up, but for some reason I can't really do that with a cursor. And here at the top, this is kind of like your home button icon. So if you tap the home button twice, well, if you could, if there was a physical home button still on iOS, then you could actually tap it twice and it will bring up that multitasking screen. So if I do that now, you can see it blurs out the application, right? So you have this privacy thing going on. And you can do the same thing with a color overlay with the other APIs, or put an image on top of it. You can do all these options. And if I go back, the blur goes away, we can actually see the app. And if I click it, it will disable this protection. And if I go to my multitask screen now, you can just see the content right there. So this could be used whenever you go to a different screen where privacy isn't as important. You can implement this any way you want. This is really one of those simple API, simple plugins with, well, it packs a lot of power, right? It has some simple functionality that you feel, you know, is really simple, but it takes some code to implement it each time for iOS, for Android, and it can be really powerful, really helpful if this is important inside of your application. Now, you don't need to do that anymore with the screen security plugin that is available for .NET MAUI. Thank you so much for watching one of my videos. Please click the like button if this was helpful to you, and that will let me know that this is a video that you would like to see more often in the future. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll be seeing you for the next video on the other side. See you for the next one.